What's going on, everybody? It's Jay Coffee Talk back again with another video for you guys. So check it out, man. We got some news. You know, we hear in the news a lot about these shootings where police officers have shot and killed innocent people. And a lot of times you hear about the shootings, you know, when they happen, but you don't hear about, you know, the outcome, what happens in court. And if you guys remember back in 2016, Charles Kinsey, he was working with an autistic, he was a caretaker for an autistic man in North Miami at a place called Mactown, a group home. There was a viral video that went around of this where he was shot by a police officer, Jonathan Aletta. And he had his hands up. If you guys remember, he was laying on the ground. He had his hands up. And he was pleading for the cop not to shoot him. He was begging with them, and the cop shot him. And the he got hit with 3 shots. He got hit in the leg. He's still disabled from the shooting. It did some serious long term damage to him. Well, this case is due to go to court now. The trial is gonna start next week. There was word it was due to start this week, but someone to do with the court was sick or something like that, so it had to be postponed. But jury selection starts next week. Now, as I said, this video was viral of this shooting. I don't understand how the dude felt the need to shoot him. It made no sense to me. Like I said, the dude sitting there begging and pleading with him, and he still decides to shoot him. Now, a couple facts that I wanted to go over. The whole situation started because when the autistic guy wandered away, he had like a toy car that was shiny metal object. Someone called it in that there was a guy, wandering around with a gun, and somehow it got to the police that it was a suicidal man, a man that was suicidal with a gun. But there was other cops that were on the scene, and the officer that shot him, Aletta, he was 150 feet away. There was 2 other cops who were 20 feet away, and they said, it's not a gun, it's a toy car. And they weren't in fear for their life. And, it was going over the radio, yeah, it's not a gun. They had determined that. But Aletta, who was 150 feet away, further away than the 2 other cops that said not to shoot, that it wasn't a gun, he decided he had to shoot though. You know what I mean? 2 guys closer. It was the word was going around, it's not a gun, it's a toy car. But the dude further away, he felt his excuse or reasoning why he shot him was that he felt that he was saving other people who were in danger. But as I said, the word was over the radio, it's not a gun. And the 2 officers who were closer, they did not feel the need to shoot this man. But this guy further away somehow missed that it was not a gun, that it was a toy car. He decided that he needed to shoot him. And he's also a trained SWAT officer. So it's pretty messed up, man. You know, a lot of times these officers, we find out they don't have the best training. You know what I mean? They're just kind of thrown on the job, depending where they're an officer at. Not all police departments, you know, require a lot of training. But him being a SWAT officer, you know, trained, certified, and all that, he had special training. So it's just kind of crazy. I really don't see how he can get out of this. I'm surprised that he didn't take a plea. You know what I mean? It took him a few months of investigating this to decide to charge him. Former officer Jonathan Aletta, it took him a couple months to decide to charge him, but they indeed did decide to charge him. But, you know, this happened back in 16, I believe July 2016. So it's finally just going to trial now. And as I said, a lot of times you hear about these shootings, you remember the videos, but it doesn't always make it to the news, you know, the way that the news of the shooting did, what the outcome is. I'm hoping that this officer is convicted. You know, I'm no cop hater, and I don't want to get into that kind of stuff in my comments that, like, you know, like, fuck the cops, or some people are like, fuck these guys who, you know, they're all scumbags. They deserve to get shot. Each case plays out different. There is some good cops, and there is also a lot of bad cops who abuse their power, who profile people. And in this situation, this guy, I really don't know what he could have been thinking. As I stated, the other factors, that there were other officers closer to the man who's sitting there with his hands up, laying on the ground, begging not to be shot. And they had determined that it was not a gun that the autistic man had. That's what's even crazier. He wasn't even the one that was supposed to have the object in question, which they determined wasn't a gun. But I don't know, guys. Now, this is the first time since 89 in North Miami, in this, you know, in this area, that a police officer was charged for an on-duty shooting, which back then was a guy named William Lozano, who was charged and convicted, but later he appealed it, and he was successful in the appeal, so the conviction was overturned, and he walked a free man. This is the first time in North Miami that since then that an officer has been charged for an on-duty shooting. Now he's charged with two counts of felony attempted manslaughter and two counts of culpable negligence. I don't have the numbers exactly what he is facing if convicted, but it's definitely gonna be some serious time. And as I said, I'm really shocked that he hasn't copped a plea, because to me, the facts just don't seem to stand in his favor at all. And I just don't see, as I've said numerous times on this blog, how he felt the need to shoot, but he did. So I don't know. We're gonna have a trial here, barring a last minute plea bargain, which could very well happen. You know, with these trials, a lot of times there's an offer on the table right up to the day the trial starts. So I don't know. We're going to have to sit back and wait and see what happens here. But I feel this man should be convicted. You know, the facts are the facts, and the facts are that what he did was some bullshit. And I don't know. I can't say that race played a factor here, but it sure seems like it, because this guy was an innocent man. You know, anyone who was there could determine it, in my opinion. So I don't know, guys. I'm going to keep you updated if this trial starts. If there's a plea bargain at the last minute, you know, stay tuned. Hit that like and subscribe. Hit that bell so you get the notifications to my videos. You know, as I said, guys, I cover a lot more than hip-hop, sports, music, news, life, and more. That's what I blog. So hit that like and subscribe. Hit that bell. Get in the comments. As you guys know, on my channel, it's all about hearing what you guys, the people, the viewers, have to say. That's the whole basis of this channel, is that I hear what you guys have to say. So please get in the comments. Very, very interested to hear what you guys got to say on this one. Now, the man who was shot, Charles Kinsey, since then, as I said, he is disabled. He has a limp, but he's carried on with his life. He mows lawns, and he works at a substance abuse center. He works two jobs, even, you know, after being disabled by being shot. So, you know, a lot of times people want to say something negative about people who are, you know, going against the police, that they're just looking for a payday. This man is working two jobs with a limp and an injury from being shot by the police officer. You know what I mean? So that ain't the case with this man. This man was an innocent man doing his job and was shot. And this was some bullshit. So I don't know, guys. Let me know what you think. Stay tuned for the updates. See you guys on the next video. It's Jay Coffee Talk signing out. Peace.